The next stop is On the Radar Radio.
Stand clear of the closing doors, please.
Yeah.
I'm not buying it. Anyway, welcome back to On the Radar, baby. You already know what's going on. Special guest.
I hate it here.
In the building. Spook, no, you love it here. That's the problem.
I love hate it here. Which camera should I look at?
This is your camera. We're rolling the interview. This is a wild way to start the interview.
This is a crazy way to start.
Now, we've been talking about New York versus Atlanta.
Because he want drama with me so bad.
I don't want no drama with you. I've just been right, though.
He's been right a little bit.
I love New York.
On camera, he's wrong.
Look, completely. This is a vote in the comments. What do you like? What city y'all like to be in more, New York or Atlanta?
Atlanta.
My people know what's up.
It's cold out here right now as we speak.
But you literally just said 5 minutes ago you like that it's cold up here. So what's the real truth?
He stayed telling my business.
I stay calling people out on their bullshit. You literally just said in there. You're like, you know, I like that it's cold up here. I like being in the cold a little bit. Why do you like the cold?
Because, you know, I be hot. I do be hot. And then it's all these lights all the time. So it'd be a little toasty. And then you go outside, you freeze right up.
Yeah, then you come back inside, then you get toasty again.
Yeah, I mean, it's straight.
That's why I love New York. Like, you have, like, your duality. Like, you could be in the summertime where it's, like, 90 degrees.
I've never been here in the summertime.
See, that's your problem.
That's why I be thinking, like, does it really get that hot?
That's your problem.
Huh? How hot does it really get out here? Because it gets hot in Atlanta. You been in Atlanta in the summertime?
Yeah, I've been out there, yeah, in the summertime. For sure.
I want to come out here. I heard y'all got a beach. You got a beach?
Of course we have beaches. We don't swim in the water, though.
I bet.
It's still nice, though. You still going to go?
Put emphasis on my stank face. I bet they don't swim in the water.
But y'all don't even have
What water y'all got? Little Hudson?
What water y'all got?
That's fine. We don't need water.
I could rent out a cabin on Overlook and wake up to sunrise on the water. Can y'all do that? Oh, I didn't think so. Anyway, welcome back to On the Radar. One of my favorite upcoming artists out of Atlanta right now. So we become
favorite?
Yeah. Well, do you want me?
I take it back. We have to keep that. That's the best thing he said.
I'm cutting it out the interview.
No, keep that.
Spook in the building. Welcome to the show.
Hello, Gabe.
How are you feeling today?
I feel great, actually.
So excited to have you.
I'm so excited to be here.
See, the sarcasm's not going to work. Not going to work.
I wasn't even sarcastic.
That's why you're saying it, though.
It wasn't even so.
This is a mess of an interview.
I love being here.
I love having you here. Anyway, Gold Digger out now. Going crazy. That's really how I found you, honestly. Like, Oya had sent me your page, right?
Right.
And he was like, oh, you have to tap in. Like, this is my artist out of Atlanta. She's going crazy right now. But it was funny because I had already found your stuff off Twitter during kind of like, I think it was like holiday break is kind of when it started going crazy,
yeah.
Right? But how you been since the viralness? I saw some different little remixes of the song, too.
I've been okay. It got me to where I am right now, so I appreciate that. And I think I'm just adapting to dealing with what comes with it, like the people and meeting all these new people this year, because I'm not used to meeting hella people. I be in the house all the time. Mm. So that's what I think is, like, different.
Mm, right. And, like, but it's cool because it reminds me of, like, when I had, like, you know, we try to call in Anisha at the beginning. Hopefully she calls back while we're doing this because we definitely need to talk. But
she didn't even call me back.
She didn't even call you back.
She didn't call me back.
But it kind of, like, reminds me of, like, when I first found Anisha, like, before So What came out. And I'm like, oh, this girl's dope. I see a vision for her. And then So What, actually, I think they filmed that while we were in Atlanta with her, too. And that kind of just went completely
produced by pop star Benny.
The GOAT, right?
So hard. I love that everybody loves him equally.
Yo, his Twitter is like my favorite.
Especially
thing.
In New York.
Yeah, I love pop star
Benny. His name has been brought up so many times since I've been here.
Yeah, I love pop star Benny. But, like, it was cool when that went viral because, like, it was kind of like the beginning of obviously everything that's led to now with the song with Lotto that she has. And it was around the time that me and her first met. And I think it's cool how I kind of feel like I get, like, a similar energy from, like, everything that's, like, happening with you right now. And especially with Gold Digger and whatnot. And I think that's just kind of been cool to watch online.
That's so nice.
You're welcome. Has there been, like, a moment, like, with Gold Digger going viral that you were like, oh, shit, like, this is, like, really happening?
Okay. When I first went viral, somebody commented on the video. And they were like, oh. No, somebody texted me, one of my friends. And he was just like, dang, Metro commented on your video? That's so crazy.
Oh, for real?
And I was like, Metro Boomin? And then I looked. It was not Metro Boomin. It was just some random nigga in Atlanta. Fucking lied. But at that point, I still was hyped, though, because I was like, okay, people are still seeing it, yeah. And somebody of, like, stature is going to see it. And right now, everybody been like, get somebody on the remix, which I want Nudie on the remix.
Let's manifest it. Look at that camera. Say you want Nudie on the remix.
Nudie, I want you on the remix. On the remix. Gold Digger. Out now.
Run it up. You know, you saying that, someone telling you that, like, Metro commented and it not being Metro feels like the ultimate episode of Atlanta. Like, you've watched Atlanta, right?
Yes.
Like, I feel like that's like the, wasn't there an episode when they went somewhere and they said that somebody famous was going to be there and it wasn't them, it was like somebody else?
But I feel like that happens all the time, though. That's happened a few times to me.
What? But it's happened in Atlanta.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because, you know, in Atlanta, they be cap a little bit. Sometimes they be capping. I'm not going to lie. They do be capping.
I feel like it's like you know how there'd be like all like the guys who pretend to be Drake?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I feel like it's like that. It's like, oh yeah, Drake gonna be there. And then you go there and you're like, I didn't order break. Like, who, like,
break,
you know what
break
I'm saying?
Is crazy. Like, that is...
I didn't order break. Like, that's kind of what this Metro Boomin shit feels like. You're like, damn, bro, I got Metro Station instead of Metro Boomin.
It was the worst thing ever because I was just sitting there looking for the comment and I'm just looking through all these comments trying to find the Metro Boomin one and it was not there.
That's crazy. How long have you been like, because obviously, you know, I think people work for these type of moments for like a long time, for like a viral moment like Gold Digger. Like, where does the origin of like you started music really go back to?
I started making songs with my friends like a year ago, and they were like just for jokes. And then Popstar Benny, he had gave me a beat like probably like 5-6 months ago in my song Suckers. That was the first song I ever dropped, and then after that, it kind of blew up a little bit, just like in Atlanta though. And so then he was just like, you know, we need to drop some more shit. And I started making more songs. And after that, I finally made Gold Digger and it went up. And that's where it went.
That's so fire. Shout out Benny. So how do you and Benny first meet? Do y'all know each other pre that or no?
I met him through my friend Reggie.
Okay, fire.
Father Reg. He put a lot of people. He shot the So What video.
Okay, got you.
Yeah, Reggie. And then he shot my Suckers video. And then after that, history.
The rest was history. Facts. Yeah, I love Popstar Benny. I love how the Bear One Boss thing that we did always is like on Twitter.
Do y'all have like put producers on here too?
Yeah. I would love to have Benny.
I would love for you to have Benny.
I would
watch that.
I think me and Benny would have a very funny hour-long conversation.
Yes.
Because I feel like me and Benny just be talking shit on Twitter.
As long as he could smoke right here, he would have a good time.
Oh, he can't smoke right here.
Oh. Sorry, Benny.
I might let him take like smoke breaks.
Sorry, Benny.
He can like go outside, take a smoke break, come back.
Okay, well, either way, he's going to have a good time.
Right, right.
We on the radar,
baby. But like, only like 6 months is like, that's... Well, 6 months, a year. Like, that's, like, very impressive and, like, very fast, too. Like, have you been able to fully comprehend, like, everything going on this quickly? Because, obviously, music wasn't, like, the choice at first. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't, like, the goal.
I was doing other stuff at first, like, wasn't stripping, but I was doing, like, pole dancing and stuff like that.
Okay.
And then that's when I got into music. And then now it's, like, I don't know. I think I'm just still adjusting, and I'm not adjusting to the fact that, you know, once you drop something, everybody's waiting for you to drop something again immediately after. So that's something that I haven't really...
It's not Anicia. Is it Nini?
No.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
I didn't think so. You are so funny.
Keep going,
okay,
though.
I don't know what I was saying anymore.
You're saying you were pole dancing, but not stripping. So you weren't at Cheetah.
No. Okay. I should have been at Cheetah.
But was it just like... It was kind of like... Like in a place where you just like sit down and like you're
no,
just like
I wasn't doing any of that. I was just doing it at home.
Oh,
it was
just
house.
Like for fun shit.
Yeah.
Okay, got you.
I was just doing it at home, and then I took it all down because it kind of gives the wrong image now that I'm making music. So it's like,
right,
you know, I fuck with the songs.
Yeah, I think it's tough because sometimes people might see that shit on like a page and they might like take you less seriously.
I had fake rap beef at one point when I first started rapping. The fakest rap beef in the world. I don't want to give her no clout. She sucks.
Well, why did you have fake rap beef for?
Because she started with me. I don't know her. Like, she was just immediately just like...
stripping videos? We're not stripping. Pole
dancing
videos.
No, not even...
Sorry. I'm so
you
sorry.
You just like her.
I'm so like sorry. I didn't mean it. I'm sorry. My bad.
I don't know. It was just so weird. She just randomly started beef with me out of nowhere. And then she saw the stripping on my page. And she was like, oh, fake rap stripper, bitch. And I was like, damn.
Damn.
Okay.
That's harsh. But it's like... Because I was on your Twitter pre this, too. I think I saw you at like Posey. You said, I fuck with the rap girls, but y'all think it'd be drama. But on God, everybody I met been cool as hell.
Yeah.
I don't know if there's any like...
I don't include her in the rap girlies because she can't rap.
Okay, got you. Understood. But like, what was like the reason behind tweeting that then? Just too much going on?
Yeah, because everybody's always think it's beef between something. And then, you know, when people have a certain amount of, like, fans, they're going to create their own narrative, try to compare you. Like, when Gold Digger went viral on Twitter, I got compared to so many people, and some of the people I don't even listen to. So it's just like, you're just creating these narratives on your own. They create them themselves and just push it to the media.
Yeah. I always reference this interview that was really good that Flo Milli and Lotto did together, like the artist on artist, I think, for Hollywood Reporter. And they had talked about how, like, I think it was that interview, they had talked about how, like, people on Twitter and social media would try to pit them against each other.
Yeah.
But, like, for what reason? You know what I'm saying? None at all.
I have no idea. I think they just want to see the drama. But at the end of the day, a lot of the rap girls that I've met are super genuine.
Yeah.
So it's like, there's really no reason to beef about anything.
Yeah.
If anybody is beefing, well, if you see it on the internet, it's 9 times out of 10 fake.
That's what it feels like, too. It feels like people just do shit just to do shit sometimes.
Yeah, it's fake. It probably never even came from that artist's mouth.
Right. Well, like, if we're talking about, like, the rap girls, obviously, you got a joint coming with Anicia. Is it done already? Recorded already?
Oh, well, we recorded one, but we're still working on the other stuff.
Okay, but the song is recorded and done.
No, we didn't announce it yet.
It's coming, anyway.
It's not done.
It's not done, but the collab is on the way.
Yes.
It's happening. But, like, with Anicia, like, how did you and Anicia first meet? Was it through Benny, too?
No, me and her met, like, years and years ago because we both were dating someone and we met through them. I was dating someone and I met her through them.
Gotcha, like friend of a friend type shit. And then, like, how did y'all stay in contact this whole time? And then that's when the music stuff came about too?
Well, she was already doing, like, well, she didn't start doing music for real. She was just like doing little stuff. And I was telling her, like, you know, this shit hard. She had this one song called Gulag that she never dropped. And I hope she drops it because it was so hard. That was like one of her first songs, I think. And after that, it was really like, we just was kicking it for a long, long time. We became close friends. Then she started taking the music serious. And then I started taking my music serious. And it just became what it is.
And then now it's just like y'all are in this, like, amazing space together.
Yes, because everybody always brings her up when, like, I don't know. Everybody brings her up when it's, like, with me, too.
No, I mean, like, in the
no, right. I like that, though.
No, but I'm thinking in, like, not even just, like, in a youth sense. I think in, like, the broader span of, like, what's going on in Atlanta right now with, like, the young wave of, like, new people coming up. Like, you, her.
Me and Bear went to high school together.
Get the fuck out, for real?
We went to Cedar Grove.
Bear got a story with everybody, huh?
Bear is my friend, yeah.
He's Benny the Butcher's nephew.
Benny the Butcher's nephew. Arrested with Playboy Cardi. Two Chainz' godson.
Arrested with Playboy Cardi.
Bear's life is hilarious, but it's, like, fun.
Yeah, I'm going to interview him about, I talked to his manager, like, I'm like, bro, I need to be the first person to interview him about this.
You have to.
Because it's good, because me and Bear, we didn't get to do the interview last time, but I know, like, when I do, it's going to be hilarious.
And he's a great vibe.
I love Bear. But, like, when I mentioned that, I meant in, like, the broader scheme of, like, kind of like this underground scene in Atlanta, right, that's becoming mainstream, obviously.
Yeah.
That, like, in my head, like, I put you, obviously, the girls in. I got, like, Tony, Pilot.
Tony's hard.
So on and so forth.
Pilot was in the Gold Digger video.
Yeah, exactly. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I think about all these people and, like, kind of, like, the culture that you guys are cultivating within this new music. Mm-hmm. And I really love it, though. Like, it's, like, this new wave of Atlanta that's, like, not, like, the drill shit or not, like, the trap shit. It's, like, somewhere, like, in the middle and, like, underground but mainstream. You know what I'm saying? Like, at least that's how I think about it.
Like it. Wait, what is the question?
No, it wasn't a question. It was just a statement. Oh. I was just giving you your flowers. For real.
I liked it.
Yeah.
I liked the statement. I thought you were asking me something.
No. It was just a statement because, like, I'm just giving you you and everybody the flowers for, like, the way that y'all creating. Like, I really love to see it.
It's really nice.
And it's, like, fresh. I think that's the thing. It's, like, music is getting kind of, like, not boring, but, like, a lot of it gets repetitive. So, like, when I see stuff like that, and especially, like, all y'all also being cool with each other, like Himward, for example.
You know I fuck with Himmy.
Love Himmy. Him
so
Jones,
hard.
Everything.
Did you hear his new song that he just...
I did, yes.
That shit is hard.
I love Himward. But, like, again, that same circle of people, you like, y'all are keeping music down there fresh and kind of, like, new and interesting to me.
Yeah, because 9 times out of 10, everybody kind of knows each other in a way.
Right.
So it makes it even better when everyone gets together to, like, create. Because then you can never know what you're going to make.
Right. So where are you at right now? Like, what are we cooking up? Like, what are we working on?
I'm dropping a tape February 5th.
Dope. By the time you'll see this, go check it out. If it's on the way, if it's out, go run that up. What's the tape called?
I don't have a name for it yet.
So you have it dropping it in like...
No, I don't have... I already finished the tape.
Yeah.
I just don't have a name for it yet.
It's coming out like 17... No, like 20-ish days?
Mm-hmm.
No name? Is it all you on it?
Yeah.
Okay.
No features.
No features. It's all you. Yep. What did the name Spook like? Where did that come from?
It came from a book.
Which book?
It's called The Spook's Apprentice by Joseph Delaney.
Mm.
And I used to read it a lot in middle school. And I kept reading the series while I was in high school. And it just made so much sense because I liked the Spook. Like, he was just the hero in the book. So I'm the hero.
Right. You're the main character.
Facts. Real. I have a song called Main Character.
There you go. Pow. Real Gemini shit.
Real Gemini shit.
So the project comes out February 5th. How many songs is it?
Eight.
So go check that out when it's out. Remix with Nudie, hopefully, down the line.
Please, we're manifesting that.
What else you want to do this year? What else is, like, the plan? Like, what do you hope to accomplish this year? You're already off to a pretty good start.
I know. I accomplished this. This was kind of one of my goals for, like, 2024.
Oh, you made it.
It was.
You did that in 18 days.
It's crazy because I didn't even know how I was going to make this work, like, because it kind of popped up randomly, like, me being able to do this. And I was like, damn, I have so much shit going on in Atlanta, and I'm about to go shoot a video as soon as I get back, like, off the plane. And so I was like, I don't know if I can make it for On the Radar, but my manager pushed it. Thank you, Oya. He pushed this out. Yeah, he pushed this shit so hard. I was like, all right, I got to be here.
How do you meet Oya, too?
Social media.
Okay.
Because at the time when Gold Digger went viral, like, a whole bunch of managers was hitting me because I didn't have nobody. It literally was just me. And he hit me up, and he kind of stood out to me because when he first called me, he called me with his wife and, like, his family and stuff. He introduced me to his people first before anything, and I fuck with that because it's like, you know, he's family-oriented, and he's going to have your best interests at heart if you really think about it. Like, anybody who's family-oriented, they're going to have your best interests. Yeah. To me, personally, I think that.
That's fire, man.
Yeah.
Shout out. Do you listen to Oya's old music?
No, I never heard it. He never played it for me.
Is it not on streaming anymore? He took it off?
I don't know. You listen to it?
Yeah, I used to love his music. That's how me and Oya became friends.
He never showed it to me, but he always tells me that he has music.
You never listened to, like, you never looked him up once on? Or
no.
He deleted all his music off streaming?
I mean, in my own mind, so I never thought to, like, shout listen to it. He sings? Now he got his shirt off. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's when I met Oya back in, where's this project at? It was a project where he had, like, that cover, it was, like, boxing themed. Or maybe I just have it downloaded on my phone.
That's crazy.
Something like that. But yeah, Oya made music for sure.
He got
for
music.
Sure. Well, I'm going to the album. I found it. It's called Loverboy. This is like his Loverboy EP.
You so tapped in. I don't be thinking you're as tapped in as you are. You know that? Okay.
Yeah. What do you mean you don't think I'd be as tapped in?
Because, like, when people are on platforms like this, I be thinking, like, you know, you would have an assistant who'd be like, okay, this is who. But sometimes you tap in on your own, though, right?
Yeah.
And I like that.
Yeah.
Like, I think that's dope.
Yeah, like, literally, I mean, Calvin brings art. We all bring artists to the show. But, yeah. Like, what people don't realize is I be seeing everything.
But see, people like me before this will think that you don't because so many people are hitting you up, especially with
thousands of that, yeah.
Exactly. So I'm like, damn, is he even seeing any of this?
I see what's moving.
Okay.
Yeah, I see what's moving. I think there's a difference because people be like, oh, you don't see me or you ignore my messages. It's just like, no, it's just like you're not moving. So, like,
right.
It's not really like not saying it's not like I don't want to tap in. It's just like, right. I got to make sure at the same time that, like, I'm helping artists out. Like,
right.
I'm trying to build the biggest music platform in the world.
He so see y'all.
So you got to, like, you just got to move correctly. And when it's, and I tell everybody, I'm like, when it's your time, it's your time.
Thanks.
And then if, you know, if it never,
that's
happened,
a good way to go about it. But, you can't say yes to everybody.
Yeah, if it's your time, it's your time. I see shit moving. The back with Brad girl who was just here, she was moving on the West Coast. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I've seen her before on the internet.
Yeah. So, like, when I see people moving, I'm like, oh, yeah.
She rapped like, what's the dude's name? He has, like, pimp rap type vibe.
Like E-40?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what she's
it's from. Another dude. He raps like Ism. He raps about, like, Ism.
I don't know.
You know who I'm talking about. I just can't think of his name.
I can't think of it either.
I feel like you know him, though. You know everybody.
I do.
Yeah.
I do. You want to try calling Anisha one more time before I sign off this interview?
Okay, let's see.
Let's see.
One more time. If she answers.
She said, what has Gabe done for Atlanta?
We're calling you, Anisha.
That's going to be crazy. Yo, Calvin, what if you called her and she picked up?
If she did, I would be so angry with her. We literally just talked before I got here. And she told me, she was like, make sure you change the color of your light.
Yeah, she know I love her for that.
Damn. She probably at the studio.
Yo, Calvin, try calling her. Just out of my own care. She banged it on you.
They were saying you wasn't going to answer the phone. They say you wasn't going to answer the phone.
Yo, you gotta raise the volume up.
I broke my speaker.
You broke your speaker?
I did. I dropped it in the dog bowl.
I can barely hear her.
No, they can't hear you, but we love you.
Yo, Nene,
answer
hold
the phone. We're going to call you back.
Hold on. Nene, pick up Calvin's call. Tell her to pick up Calvin's call.
I just did. She said she is.
Okay, bet. Perfect. Here, give me your phone.
I dropped my phone in the dog's water bowl.
That's not. Is she there?
Yeah, the speaker is kind of fucked up.
All right, cool. Let's see. Watch her not pick. If she doesn't pick this will be crazy. This is such a.
Oh, because she has a short attention span. She probably will walk away from that phone right now.
This interview is crazy, bro.
This interview is a lot. What are we even doing?
Bro.
Just keep it ringing because she might answer.
Oh, there we go. Big Nene. What up, Nene? Hold on. I'm going to pass you near. Now that we can actually hear you, guys, get the shit off your chest.
What did Gabe do for Atlanta? Oh, what did Gabe do for Atlanta, Nene? He talking about he did so much for Atlanta. What he did?
Hold it to the mic, because now you're trying to.
He gave some people their little recognition. I ain't gonna lie.
Okay.
He put people on the map with your platform.
Okay.
Yeah. See.
For sure.
Spook trying to dumb it down a
he
little bit.
He tried to play me and he tried to play Atlanta. He said it sucks. He hates Atlanta.
I did not say it sucks that I hate Atlanta.
You think that New York is just the best thing?
Probably. That's what I'm saying. He was finna.
New York is the best thing.
Was going hard for New York. Shake his hip to it.
First of all, we don't shake our hips in New York.
He was finna shake his hip. He loved New York.
Nene, come on, let's be for real. You love New York.
New York, but y'all food is booty.
Our food is booty. What compared?
We was just talking
compared
about
to Atlanta food. First of all, Spook said New York got better food than Atlanta. Spook said Atlanta food. Spook said New York food is better than Atlanta. Look at her. Look at her. Look at her right now.
I did.
You think New York food is better than Atlanta?
It's better, but does it make me like? Does the chopped cheese get the insides running? Yes, but
Brianja, a chopped cheese ain't nothing but a chopped up burger meat, baby, with some cheese mixed inside. We can make that at the house.
Your name's Brianja?
Leave me alone, Nene. Yes.
Oh wow! Look, I just thought.
Leave me alone, Nene.
Yo, Nene, I love you. Congratulations on the lotto record ahead of time. You know I love seeing you win.
We love you.
Love you, sis. Be good. All right, I'll see you then. Bye.
Me too.
Here you go. There you go. Well, look, I appreciate you being here. EP out February 5th. Go check that out. One, it's out. Freestyle out now. Gold Digger Performance out now. Before you get up out of here, anything else you want to let the people know where they can follow you at, all that good stuff. Now's the time to do it. This camera right here.
You can follow me on Instagram at Big Daddy Spook. You can follow me on Twitter at Spook's Daughter. You can find me on Apple Music, Spook, Spotify, everything. I'm out.
Gold Digger out now. Go run up everything she has out now. Make sure you go follow her. Go show her some love. Go show her some support. Love is free. Support is free. But y'all renew that. Till next time, Spook on the Radar. We out.
Bye. On the Radar.
Love.
Love.
I was about to say.